This is a live video from Clarity Ross. Title of this video is Full Blast, meaning we have to go full blast right now, direct truth, and we will do that. But as you listen to this and watch this, be sure to relax, because the feeling that we're looking for is a seamless, panoramic, carefree, unruffled, untouched feeling, which is literally the overlay, which is called that. It's not a thing, it's not visible, it's a presence that is a felt presence. It's the effect that arises from the idea of not trying to be prime creator, and it overlays all the effects that arose from the idea of spirit trying to be prime creator. So it allows for continuity. The effects are still visible. Perception sees the effects, but the felt presence of everything that arises is this seamless, untouched, perfect reflection of identity. Existence is like a mirror that we made that reflects back a false reflection to us, so in order to help us forget who we are and where we came from, in order for us to forget who our creator was, who authored our creation. Existence is simply a reflection, a false reflection, misleading, deceptive reflection. That's all that it is. Salvation is to get a true reflection. So this seamless overlay presence, which we call that, gives us a true reflection of what we are. Because there's nothing being destroyed. There's nothing being distorted. There's no fear in it. It's seamless. It's endless. It reflects back to us the quality of our own, of our true identity that God created. The prime creator created us as seamless, endless being. So that, the term that refers to this overlay. This is some of the terminology that is going to save you an enormous amount of time and effort. All that existence does is delay. It's just a delay. And every time we try to get past that delay, the ego trots out missed delay. Dun, 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 dun. Here's missed delay. And we pay attention again. Think, oh, you know, here's something interesting that's relevant to our identity. So existence is a false reflection of what we are, designed to help us forget what we are. Why do we want to forget who we are, what we are? Well, obviously, if we want to be prime creator, we cannot remember, have any awareness that we were created and who our creator was. Otherwise, we would know then, oh, something created us. Therefore, we are not prime creator. You see how simple it is? Absurdly simple. And yet, we still have to be able to see that simplicity. It's very important to see that simplicity. If we want to be prime creators, we have to be unaware of what created us, unaware that we were created. We are a created being. If we are aware that we are a created being and that we have a creator, then how can we possibly believe we could be prime creators? In other words, be the origin of all creation. If we were created by something, by a creator, obviously we cannot be prime creator. So we have to, if we want to be prime creator, we have to try and forget, be unaware of what we are, that we were created. And the world serves that function for us. It's the great mirror of forgetfulness. And as we sit in this world and move about, go about our days and years and lives, we are continuously looking into this great mirror of forgetfulness. Ceaseless change, always different, never exactly the same. It is like we are sitting on a beach, looking out at the ocean, watching the waves come in. And we think that the waves, all this activity on the ocean, somehow has something to do with our identity. But it actually has to do with forgetting our identity. Because our identity doesn't change. As we are watching change, we are seeing a reflection, a false reflection of what we are. This world was made as a projection. Spirit is projecting this using imagination and desire. Desire to be prime creator gives rise to the play of duality, construction, destruction. Arising like waves, breaking and dissipating. The wave arises, it breaks, it dissipates. The next wave comes in, arises, breaks, and dissipates. Ceaselessly, everything in existence is arising, breaking down, and dissipates, gone. Constructivity and destructivity. It's the dance of duality, the dance of Maya, the dance of deception. The mirror with the bad reflection, the false reflection. But as we choose a new idea, the idea of not trying to be prime creator, that gives rise to that which doesn't change. An effect which remains still and calm and permanent. No arising, no breaking, no dissipating. It's just simply a quiet, gentle, still presence that overlays everything that arises in existence. And that feeling, that felt presence, is a true reflection of our identity. The quality of our identity. And then the final step is to fully feel the presence of our creator, that which created spirit. That final step is taken by the creator itself, and we don't need to concern ourselves with that at all, because we need to take the remedial in-between step, and that is to choose a new idea. Give up the idea of trying to be prime creator. That's called repentance. Repent means to give up, to change one's mind, to change the idea that one is entertaining in one's mind. To think again, to choose again, repent. Choose again, choose anew. Choose not to try and be prime creator. And then this gives, that is, this choice gives rise to this felt presence, this true reflection, this overlay. It's like a transparent overlay, equally overlaying all that arises. So there's no judgment about what to overlay and what not to overlay, because the purpose, again, is simply to give a true reflection. It's not to judge anything. There's no reason to judge anything. A false reflection is a false reflection. That's the only judgment that's necessary. And therefore, the remedy is to give a true reflection. Because again, the only purpose of existence is to give a false reflection of identity, of what we are. So the only judgment one needs to make is to decide that one wants to have a true reflection. That's it. Anything else is simply delay. Everything else is simply delay. All we are called to do is to simply make the only choice that we can make. Choose a new idea. Choose the idea of not trying to be prime creator, repent. That's the only choice we have. A choice to experience a true reflection, an accurate reflection of ourselves, of our identity. That's it. It's either that or to continue with this false reflection. And the false reflection will always be a false reflection. That's its purpose. So why do we delay? And here's where we get into the difficulty of it. Because so far, it's been a very simple explanation. Anyone can understand it. And yet we still delay. We're still interested in misdelay. So, why? Because we believe that effects can separate from cause and become something different based on their own desire to be different. So we think that the reflection, the false reflection we're getting, can somehow change. It has the power, effects have the power to change themselves without changing the idea that gave rise to them. Just like we believe as spirit that we can change ourself and define for ourselves that we're prime creator. We don't have to pay attention. It's not important what caused us. We now say, no, we're causing ourselves to be. Since we're an effect of God, we believe that effects can cause themselves to be. They don't need a cause. So we look at the world and we think the world can change. It can be made better. It can be made into some kind of reflection that we want it to be. Instead of just this miserable reflection of forgetfulness of what we are, we think somehow we can make it satisfactory to us. That it can reflect the new prime creator. Somehow we can get this universe to reflect back to us that we are prime creators. And so we are working at the level of effects. This is the great problem that we have. That's it. First part of this video explained the tremendous simplicity of simply false reflection and then choosing the true reflection. And now we see that the one trouble we have is we're working at the level of effects thinking. Again, that effects can somehow choose to be whatever they want to be, independent of cause. Just like we believe we can choose to be prime creators, independent of God the prime creator. And of course, once you believe this, then you really are trapped. Really trapped. You're trapped in false belief. Because then you don't trust reality anymore. You don't trust cause and effect anymore. And you think the only thing you can do is work with effects and get this world to reflect back to you that you are prime creator. And you believe it's possible to do that. And indeed, the entire world is frantically engaged in this effort to work at the level of effects. But the truth is, only focusing on the level of cause, that's the only level where true change can take place, meaning choosing a different idea, choosing the idea of not trying to be prime creator. That is what brings about different effects. That is what brings about the overlay, the seamless, gentle, peaceful overlay over all existence. That's what brings that about. And that reminds us of our true identity. But meanwhile, the world is rejecting that and pursuing all out, working at the level of effects, trying to change the world, quote-unquote, making it better, making it more peaceful place. Underlying is the desire for the world to reflect back to spirit, that spirit is prime creator. That is literally what we are doing and have been doing for a long, long, long time. Here on this world and other worlds and other places, other dimensions, etc. That will never work. What kind of conversation can you have with never? Consider that. Can you have a conversation with never? When you say it will never work, what kind of conversation then can you have? Puts an end to conversation, doesn't it? If we are conversing, then somehow we have denied the never part of the situation. So, on the spiritual path, you must allow the never into the equation, because that's what cuts off delay. That's what moves you past delay. That's what gets you to turn away from missed delay. Because what kind of conversation can you carry on when never is what you're addressing? You can never, ever be prime creator. You can never, ever get this world to reflect back that you're prime creator. You can never separate cause and effect. You can never succeed working at the level of effects. Those are all never statements. And when you accept the never part of the equation, that ends conversation, and you go straight to simply explanation and clarification. No more conversation. The spiritual path is not about conversation, it's about clarification. Always. Whoever is doing the clarifying has to have never as central to the equation. Absolutely. Impossible has to be at the center of all clarification. We are attempting to do the impossible, to accomplish the impossible, to be prime creators. We can never accomplish that. We're attempting to work at the level of effects, thinking that this will enable us to accomplish it. And we're ignoring the level of cause. We're ignoring the simple remedy of choosing a new idea. Repentance, drop one idea, pick up another one. Exchange ideas, very simple. We're ignoring that. Whole point of spiritual clarification is to remind us how simple it is and that we've been ignoring the obvious remedy, which is to choose a new idea. The idea of not trying to be prime creators will bring about this seamless overlay that allows continuity for us. We won't feel as if all of our experiencing is suddenly vanishing. No. It's still there. It's just that we are feeling that it doesn't cause any, has no effect upon this felt presence at all. Nothing. In other words, there's no attempt to get rid of anything. No attempt at negation. So this feeling is there and it's not experiencing any negation, any deterioration, any dissipation. Very simple that they call it that. I am that. Those who realize have said this, I am that. that, meaning it has no, it's not a distinct form because it overlays all forms. It's not a distinct feeling that overlays all feelings. It's not a measurable, distinct anything. That's why it's called that, which just is a non-definite term. Immeasurable. Has no boundaries, cannot be measured, it's seamless. It's unmoving, doesn't need to move. Doesn't need to go anywhere. It's just an overlay over everything. It's a simultaneous overlay. It's not like some vast wind that goes rushing across the universe, touching everything. No, it's a simultaneous overlay over everything. So, our goal is to experience that I am that. In other words, my identity is that. This overlay is reflecting my identity back to me. That is a true reflection of my identity. That's a clear way of saying it. I am that, meaning that is reflecting my identity truly, in a true, accurate way. And therefore reminding me, the one who has tried to forget identity, reminding of what identity really is, what my identity really is. Now, the title of this video is Full Blast. We need to go full blast. Because the efforts to focus on effect, to focus exclusively on effect, those efforts are going full blast in this world. Exponential increase on exclusive focusing on effects is taking place in this world, and there is a free fall away from focusing on cause to the point where it's virtually extinct. And actually, it's a rather terrifying situation at a certain level, because in looking, searching for any signs of focus on cause, it's easy to find nothing. Very easy to find no evidence of it. Even though there have been teachers and teachings in this world, it seems as though we're having an extremely difficult time focusing on cause. Because of this overwhelming blitzkrieg of pressure to focus on the level of effects. And all these tools that supposedly amplify and enhance our capability to focus on the level of effects. And indeed they do just that. But this is a completely meaningless accomplishment, because we can never, in working with effects, get effects to make a lie true. We are not prime creators. It's impossible that we could ever have a true reflection of a falsity. It's impossible. The world can never reflect back to us that we're prime creators. Impossible, because we are not prime creators. So it doesn't matter how adept we are at working at the level of effect. It doesn't matter how many gadgets we have and capabilities and intelligence and smarts and training and desire and effort. That's all completely irrelevant. And it will always be so. Makes no difference. Doesn't do anything. We don't get anywhere. We're like, it's like the waves on the ocean. Watch them breaking like this. Do the waves get anywhere, really? There's a lot of sound and fury in the ocean, but it continually subsides back into the ocean. Now, of course, technically you could say it erodes the beach, etc., etc. So no analogies are perfect. But you get the gist of it, that water, impacting water, resolves back into water. doesn't get anywhere. All this sound and fury signifies nothing. No matter how we look at it, it will never make a lie true. However, we are at the crossroads now, where the pressure to focus on effects is so extreme. It is frightening. It's very scary. And most people deal with this fear, this dread, by denying it. They simply stick their head in the sand and deny it, say, that's really not taking place. And that is the great danger. We're all very prone to that. And the reason why I'm making these videos available and sharing them with the world is to rally all of you who are under this extreme duress right now. We're all under extreme duress, and we're all prone to going into denial. And then we just get shunted off into some little backwater issue that we obsess about. That has nothing to do really with salvation. It's just we feel like we need to work with effects in this some little way, and then that's the end of it for us. We're lost, utterly lost again. We don't want that to happen. We want to continually bring our attention back to the very root of the situation, the very simplicity of the situation, the neverness of the situation. Because neverness is a long time, isn't it? It's an unending time. You can never get around never. Time can never outlast never. We don't want to get embroiled in effects. We want to look for the overlay. We want to accept the overlay. We want to work towards the big net that casts over everything. The supreme net that nets the entire universe, that nets everything that arises in the universe. That's the net that we're looking for. And to that end, we want to continually develop a panoramic clarification, one that is not struggling with any particular issue that arises, but that is able to see all issues that arise in the world. All of them are simply part of the one reflection, the one deceptive, false reflection. Everything is just a crack in that mirror. The entire mirror is cracked. And so there isn't any need to struggle with any particular issue in this world at all. Because the entirety of existence must be overlaid as one. All of it. Because it's a false reflection. You can't find any true reflection in existence at all. Because it's all one. It's all one vast dynamic, ceaselessly changing, everything impacting everything else in subtle ways, arising and subsiding, constructivity and destructivity. Is there some place you can find in existence that is somehow a true reflection? No, it's not. So, go full blast. Go full blast. We are working here to up the production quality so that you can get a better boost from these videos. Get a better feeling from them. Feeling of seamlessness, vastness, endlessness, tranquility, peace, that which is untouched by the world, that which overlays the world, and continue to go towards acceptance of this overlay, this nirvana, this non-moving, utterly tranquil overlay. This is the goal. This is the big boost. This is the really big boost. And it's time to allow this to take place. Otherwise, you will certainly get pulled into working at the level of effects in some way. Even if it seems to be a small, tiny, eccentric way, it's still no way at all. So maintain your resolve to reach the goal of all spiritual effort, which is to repent, which is to choose a different idea, which is to drop the idea of trying to be prime creator, drop the idea of trying to gain false identity, a false picture of identity, and choose the idea of not trying to be prime creator. That's the goal. Do not make the efforts an end in themselves. This is the great stumbling block that we have stumbled on so many times. The means is not the end. The means is only a means to the end. The end, there is a goal, there is an end point, which is the acceptance of a new idea and then the effects of that idea, the overlay. That is the goal. There's no other goal. We don't have some other goal on the spiritual path. That is the one goal. There's only one goal to reach. Everything else is just a form of delay. So don't let missed delay turn your head. Keep your eyes on the prize. And that's the big boost. Okay. Very great. That's it.